Good afternoon and welcome to beautiful Yellow Jacket Field, where today the Jeff Davis Yellow Jackets will be taking on the Dodge County Indians in a Region 1 AA matchup. Dodge County coming in 5-1 in region play. They are 9-5 overall. They're a game back of the Jackets and the Worth County Rams. Jeff Davis 6-0 in region play, 6-7 overall, and Dodge County comes in with a high-scoring offense. They've scored 123 runs in their 14 games. So it'll be a big task for our pitching today to hold down this potent Dodge County Indian offense. The Jackets and Indians are neck and neck in this Region 1 AA race. Jeff Davis and Worth at 6-0. Dodge at 5-1, one game back. You've got Cook and Fitzgerald both 0-3, 4.5 games back. Berrien County, who picked up a win over Dodge last week, they're 1-5, 5 games back. Sumter County bringing up the rear, they're 0-6, 6 games back here in the early part of region play. So sit back, tune in, and thank everyone who's joined us here today, and we'll be ready for action here shortly. Right now, we're going to take a 2-minute timeout. This is the Jeff Davis Hospital Baseball Network.
Dairy Queen of Hazelhurst is proud to sponsor Jeff Davis Athletics. Whether you're celebrating a victory or cheering on your favorite team, DQ Hazelhurst is the ultimate destination for post-game happiness. Fuel your winning spirit with our mouth-watering grill burgers and cool off with our signature soft-serve ice cream. The perfect way to celebrate every triumph on and off the field. Make Dairy Queen Hazelhurst your post-game tradition, because in Hazelhurst, we know how to score big on flavor and fun.
Go Jackets!
Make tailgating easy and delicious with help from Three Rivers Meat Company in Hazelhurst. Three Rivers Meat Company offers specialty cuts of beef, pork, chicken, and seafood. They also have several types of the in-house made fresh sausage. If you need a grill, they're an exclusive dealer for Traeger Grills in Hazelhurst. To place your order in advance, call 912-551-9621 or visit their beautiful meat counter at 90 West Coffee Street. Go Jackets from Derek Wooten and the meat professionals at Three Rivers Meat Company in Hazelhurst.
At Altamaha Hall Bank and Trust, we strive to help you live your best life. That means offering loans for nearly any dream or goal. With competitive rates, local processing, and quick decisions, we can customize a loan to fit your needs. This is Misty Boatwright, Relationship Manager at the Hazelhurst Branch. Come see me today at 57 North Tallahassee Street or visit our website at altamahall.bank. And let's work together to achieve your financial goals. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
The Bank of Hazelhurst is Jeff Davis County's only locally owned and operated bank, serving their friends and family since 1906. They offer a wide array of services, including personal, commercial, and electronic banking services, along with mortgage and ag lending. For more information on the services they offer, call them at 912-375-4228. Download their banking app or contact them online at bankofhazelhurst.com. The Bank of Hazelhurst. When others have their branches, they have their roots.
Welcome back to Yellow Jacket Field, where today the Jeff Davis Yellow Jackets taking on Dodge County Indians in a Region 1 AA matchup. Jeff Davis 6-0 in region play. Dodge right on our heels. They're 5-1 in region play. So a big, big matchup here today, as the Indians always a tough customer. They're a young team, but they're scrappy, and they'll be the ones that will sit there and you think you might have them down and out, and all of a sudden here they come roaring back. They took 2 out of 3 last week from Berrien County. Also in action today, Fitzgerald is at Sumter County for a single game. Big series starting on Wednesday. Worth County and Cook will be facing off each other in the 3-game series. They'll start tomorrow with a single game at Cook. So, big matchup here. Your Mitch's Pharmacy field condition report. The field looks in to be great shape here. Coach Glass and his staff keep this thing groomed to a tee. We have Chamber of Commerce Day with a bright sky, no clouds, a little bit on the cool side, and a very light breeze. But as long as you're in the sun, it feels mighty good. Right now, home plate is in shadows, but bright sunshine elsewhere on the field. We'll see those shadows move. By the time game starts, home plate should be completely out of the shadow. But some key players for the Dodge County Indians. Landon Fordham is a right-handed pitcher, also will start at shortstop today. Ty Moore is also a right-handed pitcher, and he's getting the start at second base. Riley Williams, a left-handed pitcher, will start at first base. The starting pitcher today for the Indians will be designated hitter, cleanup batter, Holden Thomas. So there's your matchup for today. Of course, the Jackets coming in as one of the preseason favorites. Got off to that rough start with a 0-7 non-region record, but you look at who we played in those games and the results, they were all either one or two run games, except for that one game against, in the opening game against Class 7A defending state champion Lowndes County. The Jackets had, that was a one run game until the sixth, when Lowndes exploded for five runs to take a big lead. The Jackets did battle back and put a couple more on the board to make it a full run difference. But here in region play, the Jacks have been 6-0. They swept in the first series of region play. They swept Cook, who was preseason or coming in and at that time was ranked number 3 in the Journal Constitution top 10 polls for that week. So the Jackets, a big sweep over the number 3 ranked team. Dodge County opened up with a 3-game sweep. They took 2 out of 3 last week from Bering County. Of course, the Jackets last week swept 3 games from Sumter County. So big matchup here today. Jackets trying to keep this run in region play alive. The umpires and head coaches meeting at home plate, going over the rules. Let's take another 60-second timeout. This is the Jeff Davis Hospital Baseball Network.
Since their founding in 1968, the Beasley Group has become a vertically integrated leader in the forest products industry, and this growth has made them the largest hardwood sawmill in the United States and North America's foremost producer of crane mats and timbers for the energy transmission, utility, and construction industries. The Beasley Group is proud to be members of the Hazelhurst and Jeff Davis County community. They are also proud supporters of all Jeff Davis High School sports. Go Jackets from the Beasley Group.
CNH Creative Flooring can make your floors beautiful. They are this area's foremost experts when it comes to concrete grinding, polishing, crack repair, and epoxy coatings. They offer hundreds of color epoxy flake systems to choose from, custom metallics, neat coats, inlaid emblems, and much more. Whether it's your home, garage, man cave, pool deck, sidewalks, porches, or carport, let us help you make it gorgeous, safe, colorful, and skid resistant. Call Daryl Hutto at 912-381-9037 or Cody Carter at 912-592-5493 or message them on Facebook.
We're back here at Yellow Jacket Field where the meeting continues at home plate with the coaches, and only see one umpire at this time. He might be kind of taking their time on this one, waiting for the other umpire to make his appearance. I've not seen the other one, but of course, make sure everybody is aware of the schedule change. The doubleheader originally scheduled for Friday at Dodge County has been moved to Thursday. There'll still be a 4 o'clock start. That will be played on Thursday now instead of Friday over in Eastman at Dodge County. The Jackets will don their navy blue jerseys with the navy numbers trimmed in letters and numbers trimmed in gold, the white pants with the blue stripe down the legs, and the white caps, navy bill with the interlocking JD. Dodge County red jerseys with gray numbers, gray pants with red stockings and gray caps with the red bill and the stylized letter D on the front of the cap. Big, big matchup, region play as we're on the way. The other umpire finally making his way out onto the field. Let's go ahead and get you the starting lineups for today's game. First, for the Dodge County Indians, head coach Matt Herring. Lineup will go this way. Leading it off, second baseman Ty Moore. Batting second, the left fielder Kendall Yawn. Shortstop Landon Fordham will hit third. Batting cleanup, the pitcher and the designated hitter Holden Thomas. Gavin Fordham will be in right field hitting fifth, hitting sixth. Catching became Mincy. First baseman Riley Williams will hit seventh. Batting eighth at third base, Carson Jones. And batting ninth, center fielder Ashton Pitts. And now for your Jeff Davis Yellow Jackets. Head coach Paul Glass brings an overall record of 504 wins against 263 losses into contest today. Leading it off, playing second base, will be Ethan Picanso. Batting second, the right fielder, Hayden Turner. Designated hitter Duke Stone will hit third. Batting cleanup, first baseman Alex Mason. Pitching and hitting fifth will be Carter Mullis. Batting sixth, playing center field, Trayton Webster. Left fielder Jude Worthington will hit seventh. Batting eighth, playing third base, Jackson Sayer. And batting ninth, at shortstop, Eli Saunders. Dylan Kerlock will be behind the plate defensively for the Yellow Jackets. So Jeff Davis' lineup will go Picanso, Turner, Stone, Mason, Mullis, Webster, Worthington, Sayer, and Saunders. Teams taking the field as we'll be set for action here very, very shortly after the playing of the national anthem. What a beautiful day for baseball. Just a little on the cool side, but we'll take that over the liquid stuff that we've had to work around so much. We'll pause here for the national anthem. Honoring America with the national anthem here at Yellow Jacket Field. Let's take a break. We'll be back with opening pitch after this timeout on the Jeff Davis Hospital Baseball Network.
Cypress Hill Tent Shop, located in Graham, Georgia, offers tenting solutions for every need. Sunroofs, tent matching, removal of old tent, and new installation using state-of-the-art equipment and machines. Cypress Hill Tent Shop uses union tent, guaranteed not to bubble, fade, or discolor over time, and offers both carbon and ceramic tent options. Tent protects the inside of your vehicle and keeps the inside cooler in the summer and warmer in the winter. We also offer pickup and drop-off options for your convenience. Call us today.
Go Jackets!
EP American Footwear in Hazelhurst is proud to be a part of the Hazelhurst Jeff Davis community and are proud sponsors of all Jeff Davis County sports. If you're looking for a great job with a great company, they are hiring for all shifts. You can apply in person Monday through Friday, 8 to 5, at 10 North Hill Street in Hazelhurst. Go Jackets from all the folks at EP American Footwear of Hazelhurst. Go Jackets!
Defensively for the Yellow Jackets, outfield left to right, Jude Worthington, Trayton Webster, and Hayden Turner around the horn. Third to first, you've got Jackson Sayer, Eli Saunders, Ethan Picanso, and Alex Mason. Behind the plate is Dylan Carelock, and on the mound, senior right-hander Carter Mullis, a win and a loss on the season, 3.18 ERA. In 11 innings, he's allowed 10 hits, 7 runs, 5 of them earned, 2 walks against 18 strikeouts. Ty Moore, Kendall Yawn, and Landon Fordham, the first three due up for Dodge County. And again, the Mitch's Pharmacy field condition report. It's a perfect day for baseball with a bright sky and hardly a cloud in sight, and perfect conditions on the playing surface. First pitch from Mullis is in for a strike. Caught the corner. 2-0. Foul ball down the right side. Oh, and 2 to count. That missed way up high. 1 ball, 2 strikes. To Ty Moore leading off the game for the Indians. That again missed high. That ends up the count at 2-2. Thank everyone who's joined us on the Jeff Davis Hospital Baseball Network today. Beasley Group live stream. Carter's missed 3 in a row up high after getting 2 call strikes and a foul ball. Now the count's full, 3-2. That missed inside, ball 4. So a leadoff walk for Moore. After Carter got ahead, a runner aboard with nobody out for Kendall Yawn. It's very frustrating as a pitcher. You get way ahead in the count and then just can't finish it up because everything seemed to sail high on him. See if Carter can get the ball down from the stretch now. Runner leads at first. Showing bunt, but that one again sails high. That's 5 in a row. Up above the shoulders by Carter Mullis. Jackson Sayer playing right on the edge of the grass at third, expecting the bunt. And the bunt's going to third. Sayer feels it. Will fire to first. Low throw. Picanso makes a good scoop. 5-4 on the sacrifice. And that'll move the runner to second. The one away for Landon Fordham, the shortstop. Fordham, a tall, lanky, right-handed batter. He may be one of the taller shortstops you'll see. He's up there in Alex Mason, Duke Stone territory, well over the 6-foot mark. Preseason all-region selection. Missed up and in. Running scoring position for the Indians with one out. Mullis trying to work and finish his delivery and get the ball down in the zone. There it is, but it missed inside. Got it down, but a little bit in. Two balls, no strikes. And that didn't miss the inside corner by much. Check of the runner at second. Up and in. 3-0. Carter in danger of giving up his second walk of the inning. Runner at second, one out. After a leadoff walk, Moore's the runner at second. Call strike, letter high. Might have got a little bit of a help right there from the home plate umpire. Run makes a count, 3-1. Carter still really having to work to try to get the ball down. Everything's been up. That's a danger. Throw back to second. Close, but not in time. Eli Saunders trying to sneak in behind the runner. The shadows have cleared the home plate area, so nothing to contend with there. It's one being in sun, one being in shadow. Chop foul, third base side. And Carter's battle back to run the count 3-2. Again, Dodge County at 5-1 in the region, right behind the Jackets, and Worth County both at 6-0. Worth will be taking on Cook in a matchup of Journal Constitution top 10 teams. Pop foul. Right on top of the roof here. Count will stay 3-2. We'll get you the Week 5 Journal Constitution poll a little bit later on in the game. In year two of this JDH TV student-led broadcast live streaming project that we're working with, that I'm working with, boy, got a really pleasure for me as old and gray on the top, or mostly bald on the top too, to work with these young students on these broadcasts. Up high, ball four, and another walk. This puts first and second with one out. We'll bring the pitcher designated hitter, Holden Thomas, to the plate. They list him as pitcher and also the designated hitter in the starting lineup. That way, should they have to change, take him out of the game pitching, he can still remain in the game as in the lineup as a designated hitter. Allowed to do that without having actually a specific designated hitter. That's a good strike on the outside corner, knee high. Nothing in one. So two on for dangerous batter. Chance for Holden Thomas to help himself out. Liner down the left field line, but hook foul. 0-2, and he didn't miss clearing the bases, but by a couple of feet. Carter left a hanging breaking ball out up over the plate. But ahead of the count now, 0-2 with two on and one out. We're in the top of the first. No score, but Dodge threatening to get on the Jeff Davis Walk-In Clinic scoreboard. Just missed inside. Almost just, when I said just missed, I mean just missed the batter. He had to spin out of the way of that one. Carter brushed him off the plate. 1-2. Away. Evens a count at 2-2. Carter works from the very end of the pitching rumble on the first base side. Come set at the belt. Grounded foul. Count remains 2-2. First game of a three-game set with the Indians. The Friday doubleheader over in Eastman has been moved to Thursday. Still a scheduled 4 o'clock first pitch. Popped him up. Just going to get out of play. Count stays 2-2. Moore and Fordham. Moore led off with a walk. Yon bunted him to second. Then Landon Fordham drew a walk to put two on. Two on, one out. A 2-ball, 2-strike count on the batter. Mullis checking the runner at second. Jess missed off the plate. A good check swing there by Holden Thomas to run the count full, 3-2. The stretch and the pitch as the runner start to go high. Chopper to third. One on the bag at third. Throw to first. Double play. Had to take a look at that on the Bank of Hazelhurst instant replay. See if we got it there. Here we go. You'll see the batter Fordham there. As he high chopped to third, Jackson Sayer leaps, comes right down on the bag, throws to first in time to complete the 5-3 double play and end the inning. No score after a half inning on the Jeff Davis Walk-In Clinic scoreboard. We'll take a break on the Jeff Davis Hospital Baseball Network.
Your eyes are your window to the world around you, and good vision is important to everyone. At Southern Eye Care, you can count on their expertise in treating all types of vision problems to help you see your best. From glasses to contact lenses, from surgical vision correction to treatment of eye disease and injury, their team is here to help take care of your eyes. Your vision matters at Southern Eye Care in Hazelhurst. Call them for an appointment at 912-375-2516 or visit them online at southerneyecarepc.com.
Experience a better way to bank at Interstate Credit Union in Hazelhurst, where they offer a wide variety of loans. Interstate Credit Union is second to none when it comes to low rates and great customer service, specializing in personal loans, new home and construction loans, and automobile loans, as well as many other types. Their broad services include personal checking, savings, business, in-person, online, and mobile banking, and much, much more. Visit them at 14 Henson Street, or call 912-375-0640, or you can contact them online at interstatecu.org.
We move on to the bottom of the first, brought to you by the Dairy Queen of Hazelhurst. Ethan Picanso, Hayden Turner, Duke Stone, the first three up for Jeff Davis. Outfield left to right for the Indians. Yon Pitts and Gavin Fordham. Third to first on the infield, Jones, Landon Fordham, Moore, Williams, Mincy behind the plate, and on the mound, right-hander Holden Thomas, who misses high for ball one. To Picanso, who comes in hitting 306, a home run, and four driven in. Swing and a miss. Evened up at 1-ball, 1-strike. Working quickly is that's a soft liner, shallow center. Center fielder, though, Pitts will come on and make the catch. One away. I'll bring Hayden Turner. Hitting 212, but has a home run and six driven in. So he's made his hits productive. Nobody on, one out. Swing and a miss. Thomas, a rather imposing picture up on the mound. Missed up and away at 73. big, solidly built right-hander. That's 77 and fouled on the right side. That's going to get out of play. Catcher Mintz in, first baseman Williams over, looking at it close, but it's on top of the roof here. A ball and two strikes to Turner. Hayden, a preseason second team All-State selection by the Georgia Dugout Preview magazine. That hit him right between the shoulder blades. Was all speed pitch, so not like he got drilled by a fastball. So one on, one out. But Duke Stone, who's hitting 265, has a pair of Williams Brothers Trucking Company home runs and leads the team with 9 runs driven in. Runner at first with good speed with one out. 72 on the outer edge for a call strike. So we're going to have a pretty generous strike zone here so far in the early going. That's a little bit high. A ball and a strike to count. Turner's at first. After an out, hit by a pitch. Way high, 2-1. If you get it up there around Duke Stone's cap, Bill, you have really missed high, because Duke checks in at 6'5". Ripped left field, but pull foul. 2-2 the count. Stone, who has signed a letter of intent, will continue his playing career in the SEC for the Mississippi State Bulldogs. 2-2. Lifted high in there to center field. Center fielder going back. That ball's pretty well hit. He's back to the wall. It's halfway up the wall in center, bouncing back. They're going to wave Turner. Stone's going to try to get three. He's going to be in there. The ball sails past third base, but quickly backed up. An RBI triple. Let's see if we can see that on our Bank of Hazelhurst instant replay. See Stone, as he's already hit the ball. Now he's around second, pauses there, and motors into third ahead of the throw. The 1-0 Jackets. Brings out it's Mason to the plate. He takes a strike. Mason hitting 293. Hitting 273. No homers and 5 RBIs. Fouls that one back. Oh, and 2 now on Mason. Alex is signed to play with the Georgia Southern Eagles. Hard grounded to short. Shortstop scoops it up, makes a throw on the run in time. That's going to end the inning, but the Jackets pick up a run on one hit. No errors and one left. We've got one in the books. The Jeff Davis Walking Clinic scoreboard reads 1-0 Jackets. Let's take a break on the Jeff Davis Hospital Baseball Network. 1-0. That was only the second out of the inning. So Carter Mullis will be at the plate. He's going to swing at the first pitch. Send that high in there to right field. Right fielder drifts back. Look, Gavin Fordham with the catch, and that will now end the inning. So no. Okay, so I missed it. Stone did come in score on the ground out by Mason. Boy, I'm really getting out of it here. So 2-0 Jackets on the Jeff Davis Walk-In Clinic scoreboard. Let's take a break. This is the Jeff Davis Hospital Baseball Network.
At Jeff Davis Hospital in Hazelhurst, we are committed to building a healthy community. We use the latest technology, and our knowledgeable team members provide exceptional, state-of-the-art care to our local community and surrounding areas. We provide a respectful understanding of care for our patients and their loved ones. For more information about Jeff Davis Hospital and the services we provide, call 912-375-7781 or visit us online at jeffdavishospital.org.
Dr. Kurt Munsiak and his staff at the Jeff Davis Walk-In Clinic have proudly served this community as the original walk-in clinic for your sick visit needs and as volunteer sports medicine for all our Jeff Davis athletics since 2014. Whether at the clinic, on the sidelines, courtside, matside, or on the diamond, Dr. Kirk is always ready to help. Give him a call at 912-375-4884 or pop in at 22 Cross Street in Hazelhurst behind Jeff Davis Hospital. God bless and go Jackets from the Jeff Davis Walk-In Clinic.
Dairy Queen of Hazelhurst takes us to the top of the second inning. Jackets up 2-0 on the Jeff Davis Walk-In Clinic scoreboard. And see if I can pay a little bit better attention this inning and not get too far ahead of myself. I had us cheated out of a run there, but 2-0 Jackets. Second run scoring on the infield ground out by Alex Mason. Swing and a miss by Gavin Fordham. He'll be followed by Kane Mincy and Riley Williams. The 0-1 call strike on a breaking ball at 74. 0-2. Hard to pick up sometimes the difference between Carter's fastball and his breaking ball because everything's got a lot of movement on it. Just off the outer edge. Pretty close pitch on 0-2. Gavin Fordham either was fooled or he's got a real good eye to take that pitch. That missed low and away. Two balls, two strikes. Carter struggling to maintain consistency on his pitches. He's already up to 28 pitches unofficially. Down low, he walked two in the first, went deep in a couple other counts, but that helped out on that 5-3 double play. Chopped third base side, but it's going to trickle foul as Dylan Kerlock out quickly. Count will stay 3-2. Gavin Fordham, right fielder, a right-handed batter. Crowds up on the plate, just a very slight open stance. Chops that one foul into the Indian dugout on the third base side. We'll look at another 3-2 pitch. Call strike three. 80 miles an hour just off the outer edge. And Carter Mullis gets his first strikeout.
Number three,
bring Kane Mincy to the plate. Mincy the catcher. That's with nobody on and one out. Weak swing on a moving pitch by Carter Mullis, nothing in one. That ball was at 75 but had a lot of movement. Chopper on the third base side, foul, 0-2. Well, Carter maybe getting warmed up and getting a little bit better rhythm on his pitching. Swing and a miss, came right after him, 74 miles an hour, letter high. Strikeout number two. Now they'll turn it over to Riley Williams. Left-handed hitting first baseman. We'll head over to Eastman on Thursday for a doubleheader. Call strike outside corner to the lefty. Carter's now settled down and he's getting ahead in the counts. Pop foul, third base side. Jackson Sayer over checking it out, but it's going to get out of play. And Carter ahead 0-2. Nobody on, two outs. We're in the top of the second. Jackets up 2-0 on the Jeff Davis Walk-In Clinic scoreboard. The 0-2 pitch. Slow roller to third. Picanzo picks it up, fires to Alex. And that's a 3-up, 3-down inning for the Indians. 2-0 Jackets as we go to the bottom of the second on the Jeff Davis Hospital Baseball Network.
Need salvage parts for your new or late model car or truck? Then you should call McCarty Auto Parts, where parts arrive daily, Monday through Friday, 8 to 5, at their location at 118 Ottomaha Road in Hazelhurst. Check out their inventory online 24-7 at McCartyAuto.com. If they don't have the parts you need, they'll find it. Call McCarty Auto Parts in Hazelhurst for all your salvage part needs. 1-800-329-7258. Go Jackets!
Make the switch to Mitch. Visit Designs and More by Brandy, located inside Mitch's Pharmacy. Brandy offers all occasion flowers, silk, and fresh. Shop Designs and More by Brandy for gift baskets for that special someone, shoes by Corky, and jacket t-shirts for the entire family. Located at 5 East Coffee Street in Hazelhurst, open 9 to 6 Monday through Friday and 9 to 12 on Saturday. Give them a call at 912-699-3784 and follow them on Facebook.
Go Jackets!
Hazelhurst Dairy Queen takes us to the bottom of the second inning. Jackets lead it 2-0 on the Jeff Davis Walk-In Clinic scoreboard. It'll be Trayton Webster, Jude Worthington, and Jackson Sayer due up for the Jackets. Hayden Turner was hit by a pitch. Duke Stone tripled him in, and then Stone scored on an infield ground out by Alex Mason to give the Jackets two runs in the first. This big Region 1 AA matchup. Tennis teams are in a big region matchup today. Here at home against Berrien County. So the lefty Webster will step in. Chopper, first base out, first baseman Fields turns, looks towards first, foot race to the bag, he beat it out. Infield, the pitcher slow getting off the mound, so an infield hit by Trayton Webster on the first pitch of the inning.
Next up, number 10. Jude
Webster came in hitting 290 with six runs driven in. Jude Worthington, a cool 500. A Williams Brothers Trucking Company home run and five RBI, showing bunt. Bunts it on the first base side. The pitcher's going to have to field. High throw to first and just got him by half a step. Jude was flying down the line. Sacrifice will move Webster into scoring position.
Up the bat, number six, Jackson Sayer.
Jackson Sayer will bat. Jackson hitting 303. Also has a Williams Brothers Trucking homer and eight RBIs. Takes one up the stairs for ball one. Jackets being aggressive. Two batters in a row. We swing at the first pitch. Has a chopper third on the second pitch. Checks the runner. Fires across. On the move after the ground out, Webster will move to third with no throw. 5-3 on the put out for Sayer.
13, Eli Saunders.
Two outs. And quickly, Eli Saunders to the plate, hitting a 194 with four runs driven in. Jackets with a runner at third and two outs. Need to get him home. That missed upstairs for ball one. Thomas wastes no time. He gets it and goes the stretch and pitch upstairs, 2-0. Soccer teams had region matchup yesterday over at Dodge County. The girls fell 4-3 in overtime. The boys won 2-0. 2-0, I guess, is the proper term for soccer. 2-1 the count to Saunders. Swing and a miss. 2-2. Girls and boys tennis teams played in the Golden Isles Invitational over in Brunswick over the weekend. Boys were runner-up. The girls were champions. Grounded toward short. Backhanded pickup by Fordham. Throw across in time. And that's going to end the inning. Jackets, no runs on a hit. No errors. We strand one. After two innings of play, Jackets 2, Indians nothing. 60-second break. This is the Jeff Davis Hospital Baseball Network.
Williams Brothers Trucking is now hiring qualified CDL Class A licensed drivers with at least 2 years over-the-road tractor-trailer experience.
Williams Brothers Trucking has an excellent benefits package. They have quarterly bonuses. They have great insurance.
They offer flexibility as far as your work schedule. You're not really pressured into starting at any certain time throughout the day.
Be home every day with family-owned and operated Williams Brothers Trucking. Apply now online.
Go Jackets!
Dairy Queen of Hazelhurst is proud to sponsor Jeff Davis Athletics. Whether you're celebrating a victory or cheering on your favorite team, DQ Hazelhurst is the ultimate destination for post-game happiness. Fuel your winning spirit with our mouth-watering grill burgers and cool off with our signature soft-serve ice cream. The perfect way to celebrate every triumph on and off the field.
You just saw the Dairy Queen of Hazelhurst, and they take us to the top of the third. 8-9-1 in the batting order for the Indians. Carson Jones, Ashton Pitts, and Ty Moore. Carter Mullis kicks and fires. Strike on the outside corner. Jones, a right-handed batter. Third baseman. Made a couple of big plays that inning. Just missed the outer edge. One ball, one strike. Be sure to stay tuned post-game for the Southern Eye Care post-game show. Call strike on the outside corner. 2-1. All three of those pitches pretty close to the same spot. All-speed pitch missed up high. Count evens at 2-2. Jones, a right-hand batter with a open stance. And about middle of batter's box. Missed low. Count full now 3-2 to the leadoff man. Mullis walked two in the first, but coached a double play grounder to end the inning. Swing and a miss. Kerlot's going to have to throw down to first to complete the putout. Three strikeouts now for Carter. Ashton Pitts, the center fielder. Going to step in from the left side. Bases are empty and one out. Missed up and away for ball one. The Jackets and the Worth County Rams lead the region with 6-0 marks. Dodge County checks in at 5-1. There's a fly ball right field right at Turner, who drifts back about three steps and makes a catch. Two away. Barron County 1-5 in region play. Cook and Fitzgerald both 0-3 in Sumter County 0-6. I'll send us back to the top of the order for Ty Moore, who walked and then was doubled off in that 5-3 double play. Takes a strike on the outside corner. Carter Sr., also been a four-year starter. That's going to be a ground ball to Picanso at short. Throws to Mason. Three up, three down. Go the Indians here in the third. Jackets up 2-0. Let's go to the break with the Jeff Davis Hospital Baseball Network.
Dairy Queen of Hazelhurst is proud to sponsor Jeff Davis Athletics. Whether you're celebrating a victory or cheering on your favorite team, DQ Hazelhurst is the ultimate destination for post-game happiness. Fuel your winning spirit with our mouth-watering grill burgers and cool off with our signature soft-serve ice cream. The perfect way to celebrate every triumph on and off the field. Make Dairy Queen Hazelhurst your post-game tradition, because in Hazelhurst, we know how to score big on flavor and fun.
Go Jackets!
Make tailgating easy and delicious with help from Three Rivers Meat Company in Hazelhurst. Three Rivers Meat Company offers specialty cuts of beef, pork, chicken, and seafood. They also have several types of the in-house made fresh sausage. If you need a grill, they're an exclusive dealer for Traeger Grills in Hazelhurst. To place your order in advance, call 912-551-9621 or visit their beautiful meat counter at 90 West Coffee Street. Go Jackets from Derek Wooten and the Meat Professionals at Three Rivers Meat Company in Hazelhurst.
Derek Wooten of Hazelhurst takes us to the bottom of the third where the Jackets lead it 2-0. Mitch's Pharmacy field condition report. We're beginning to see shadows stretch across the infield from third base to second base and a couple of stripes of shadows out in left field. The pitching mound and home plate still in bright sunshine. Top third of the order for the Jackets, Picanso, Turner, and Stone. Ethan hit a little soft liner to center his first time up. Takes one way up and away. Holden Thomas continuing to work on the mound for the Indians. 2-0. Jackets put up two in the first. Hold the 2-0 lead on the Jeff Davis Walk-In Clinic scoreboard. That missed wide. Three balls. Three and oh the count. That's ball four. So Picanso draws the leadoff walk.
Next up, number nine, Hayden Turner.
Ranked Hayden Turner, who was hit by a pitch and came around to score. The Journal Constitution top 10 poll for week five. North Cobb Christian first, Mount Perrin second, the Appling County Pirates at third. There's a call strike. Worth County Rams, a Region 1 AA team at fourth, Redan fifth, Model sixth. Runner goes from first, pitches up and away, and Picanso steals that base easily. Checking in at number seven this week are the Jeff Davis Yellow Jackets. The Cook Hornets, who Jackets swept earlier, are in eighth, Landmark Christian nine, and the Vidae Indians move into the polls at number 10. That one missed high. Two balls and a strike. Runner at second with nobody out. The stretch and the pitch. Up high again. 3-1. Indians playing even with the bag at third, right on the edge of the grass at first. Kind of pinching up the middle. And that's another walk. Turner will trot down to first. Two on, nobody out, and he's going to get the Dodge County coach out of the dugout. Try to talk to his pitchers. Duke Stone strides to the plate, who had an RBI triple his first time up. While we've got a minute, we want to thank our sponsors, Cypress Hill Tent Shop, McCarty Auto Parts, and Three Rivers Meat Company. And thank all of our fine sponsors. You see our alumni sponsors that scroll across the bottom of our scorebook. And, of course, we thank the Beasley Group for their sponsorship of all of our live streams. We'll have to pack all this stuff up and hit the road on Thursday to go to Eastman for a doubleheader. Trying to get ahead of the weather. And I think it's prom Saturday, isn't it, Ethan? And again, give us maybe another day to give these guys a break before prom sets in. So Duke Stone will step in with two on and nobody out. Stone again launches one high. This one not so deep. Right fielder Fordham is going to make the catch in shallow right. And there's one away.
Number 14, Alex Mason.
So 2-on-1 out for Alex Mason. That missed outside. Check swing. 1-1. Jackets up 2-0 on the Jeff Davis Walk-In Clinic scoreboard. And that hit him. So two walks and a hit batter. Going to load the bases with one out here in the bottom of the third. And that would bring Carter Mullis to the plate, a chance to help himself out. He skied it to right his first time up. So Picanso's at third, Turner at second, Mason's at first. Just one out, a chance for the Jackets to hang a crooked number on the board. Call strike on the wide outside corner. A generous corner call there. Almost hit him inside. One ball, one strike. Good stop by Mincy, the catcher, on a backhanded pickup to keep a run from scoring on a pitch that was low and away. 2-1 the count. Swing and a miss. Evens up the count at 2-2. Ducks on the pond here with one out. And Carter Mullis, who's been swinging a hot bat lately, standing in. They got center fielder shifted way around to left. He's going to try to go the opposite way, fouls it off. Count will stay 2-2. That pitch was up and away, and Carter went with it. But too wide on the right side. Two balls, two strikes. Bases full of Jackets. High chop third. Third baseman backpedals. He's going to run and get a force at third. A run's going to score. So Picanso comes to score. Turner is out at third. Five unassisted. Put Mullis aboard on the fielder's choice and give him an RBI. The 3-0 Jackets. On the Jeff Davis Walk-In Clinic scoreboard. Trayton Webster, who singled his first time up, will step to the plate. Light back up the middle. That's a base hit. They're going to wave Turner around third. He's going to score easily without a throw. Check that. Mason will come around to score to make it 4-0. Give Webster his second hit of the day, an RBI single. Runners first and second now. 4-0 Jackets on the Jeff Davis Walk-In Clinic scoreboard. Jude Worthington will bat. He had to sacrifice his first time up. Takes it up high for ball one. Fouled that one right off either the catcher or the umpire's headgear. I'm not sure which it was. Must have been the catcher because the on-plate umpire stepping out, checking with him, make sure he's okay. Ball and a strike with two out. 2-1 the count. Runners lead at first and second. Maybe got Camo Mansiak out running for Mullis at second base. Missed inside. A 3-1. Well, excuse me, swing a little looping liner out towards short. That's going to end the inning. Well, the Jackets played a couple more on just one hit. No errors, two left. We got three in the books. Jackets lead at 4-0. This is the Jeff Davis Hospital Baseball Network.
At Altima Hall Bank and Trust, we strive to help you live your best life. That means offering loans for nearly any dream or goal. With competitive rates, local processing, and quick decisions, we can customize a loan to fit your needs. This is Misty Boatwright, Relationship Manager at the Hazelhurst Branch. Come see me today at 57 North Tallahassee Street or visit our website at altimahall.bank. And let's work together to achieve your financial goals. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
The Bank of Hazelhurst is Jeff Davis County's only locally owned and operated bank, serving their friends and family since 1906. They offer a wide array of services, including personal, commercial, and electronic banking services, along with mortgage and ag lending. For more information on the services they offer, call them at 912-375-4228. Download their banking app or contact them online at bankofhazelhurst.com. The Bank of Hazelhurst. When others have their branches, they have their roots.
Dairy Queen of Hazelhurst takes us to the top of the fourth inning. Jackets up 4-0. Yon Fordham and Thomas. First pitch swinging is a two-hopper out to Eli Saunders at short. He throws him out at first. One pitch, one out. The Jeff Davis Walk-In Clinic scoreboard. The bottom of the fifth in Sumter County, Fitzgerald Purple Hurricanes lead the Panthers 11-0. Bring Landon Fordham to the plate. Takes one low and away for ball one. Fitzgerald just two wins on the season overall, none in region play. There's a strike at the knees. One ball, one strike. Call strike on the outside corner. We said this home plate umpire, very generous on the outer edge. One and two the count. Nobody on and one out. The pitch. That was a little bit too far out. He was accounted two balls, two strikes. Fly ball center field. Webster's going to have to get on his horse. He's on the run. It's over his head. That's to the wall for extra bases. He hustles it in quickly. And a one-out double from Landon Fordham. First hit of the game for the Indians will bring Holden Thomas, the pitcher, to the plate. He hit into a 5-3 double play to end the first inning. When the Indians were threatening to jump to an early lead after a couple of free passes issued by Mullis. Now a runner in scoring position, one out, throw back, not in time. Speckled shadows now cover the mound and home plate now. Shadows have reached there. Just off the outer edge. Although the shadows on the ground, Carter Mullis was still bathed in sunshine up on the bump. And that makes a little contrast when you got shadows behind him. That can make the tough for the batter to pick up the ball coming out of the pitcher's hand. Swing and a miss. One ball, one strike. Runner at second. After the one-out double for the Indians. The stretch into 1-1. Missed high. Two balls and a strike with one out. checks the runner at second a couple of times. Now comes to the plate. Blew a fastball right on by him at 81. It's 2-2. Call strike three, got him looking on the outer edge, knee high. Strikeout number four for Mullis. Two gone. I'll bring up Gavin Fordham, who struck out looking his first time up. The Atlanta Braves had the day off in Grapefruit League play down in Florida. Azair finishing up, getting ready to start the season in Philadelphia. Throw to second. Got by. Picanso coming over to cover, but Webster backing up quickly, keeps the runner at second base. Braves have made it clear their mentality going into the season this year is World Series or bust. They think they've got the pitching and the offense to go all the way. Up and away for ball one. Set all kind of records offensively last year. And then Spencer Strider led the league in strikeouts by a wide margin. Braves had the leading home run hitter in first baseman. Has a strike down at the knees. Ronald Acuna posting the first 40 steals, 70 home run season in Major League history as he broke both 40 and 70 in those categories. 41 homers, I think, and 73 stolen bases. That's a little bit low. 2-1. So it should be a big season as they'll open up against arch rival Philadelphia in a little over a week. And, of course, the bitter taste in all Braves fans' mouths from that the Phillies bounced us from the playoffs last year. That was a wide pitch, a good stop by Dylan Kerlock to keep the runner at second. 3-1 the count now to Gavin Fordham. I'm a Braves fan from way back. Back when they first moved to the Atlanta with Henry Aaron, Rico Cardi and the guys. That was fouled off. Shows you how old I am. I used to listen to my transistor radio to Milo Hamilton and Ernie Johnson Sr. call the games and get in trouble when my mommy catch me with that radio under my pillow in the bed when I was supposed to be going to sleep. And they were playing games against the Dodgers out on the West Coast late at night. A 3-2 pitch. That's lifted in there to left field. Worthington moving over towards the line. He's got room to make the catch. And that'll end the inning. No runs, a hit, no errors, one left. We go to the bottom of the fourth. Jackets lead it 4-0 on the Jeff Davis Hospital Baseball Network.
Since their founding in 1968, the Beasley Group has become a vertically integrated leader in the forest products industry. And this growth has made them the largest hardwood sawmill in the United States and North America's foremost producer of crane mats and timbers for the energy transmission, utility, and construction industries. The Beasley Group is proud to be members of the Hazelhurst and Jeff Davis County community. They are also proud supporters of all Jeff Davis High School sports. Go Jackets from the Beasley Group.
CNH Creative Flooring can make your floors beautiful. They are this area's foremost experts when it comes to concrete grinding, polishing, crack repair, and epoxy coatings. They offer hundreds of color epoxy flake systems to choose from, custom metallics, neat coats, inlaid emblems, and much more. Whether it's your home, garage, man cave, pool deck, sidewalks, porches, or carport, let us help you make it gorgeous, safe, colorful, and skid resistant. Call Daryl Hutto at 912-381-9037 or Cody Carter at 912-592-5493 or message them on Facebook.
Dairy Queen of Hazelhurst takes us to the bottom of the fourth inning. Jackets lead it 4-0 on the Jeff Davis Walk-In Clinic scoreboard. 8-9-1 in the batting order for the Jackets. Sayer, Saunders, and Picanso will be due up for the Jackets. A lot of people out there tuned in, and maybe my partner here, Ethan Dixon, like, what the heck is a transistor radio? That's an ancient iPod. It was a battery-operated radio, a little bit bigger than a deck of cards. And I was guilty trying to slip that thing under my pillow. When laid down, I could hear it through the pillow, but nobody else could hear it outside, except my mom, who had radar ears, I guess. She could come in and catch me with that radio listening to the Braves late night, way back in the day. That was when you might get to see them three or four times a year on TV. Ethan, back then we had three channels on our TV. And you had to have a good antenna to get all three of them. That'll bring Jackson Sayer to the plate. Grounded to third his first time up. And our TVs were black and white. That's a call strike. We thought we had hit the big time when Dad came home with a color TV. That missed outside. About a 15-inch screen. Almost hit him inside. 2-1. Wife texts me, says, you know you're old when you have to explain what a transistor radio is. Has a strike down and away. This generous strike zone here. Two balls, two strikes. Hit on the ground hard to third, right by the third baseman down the line. Sayers looking for two, but the left fielder, Yawn, got over quickly to cut it off. But a leadoff single for Jackson Sayer.
Next up, number 13.
Fourth hit of the game for the Jackets. Bring Eli Saunders to the plate, who grounded to third his first time up. Third baseman's been busy boy over there this afternoon for the Indians. Bunt attempt that's fouled. Really need to see if we can find a spark to get Eli's bat going. Runner goes. Pitches high. The throw down is not in time. Sayer steals the base. One ball, one strike to Eli. Got a big gap in left center. See if Saunders can take advantage of it. Runner at second. Outside, 2-1. Keeps pitching that way. Just ride with the pitch and hit that gap in right center. That missed inside. 3-1. I want to say a big thank you to the Beasley Group for providing these live stream sponsorship for us. Swing and a miss. Saunders goes down swinging.
Of the bat, number two, Ethan Picanto.
Bring up Ethan Picanto. First strikeout for Thomas. Runner remains at second. That's popped foul on the right side. Boys now are 7-0, boys soccer team 7-0 in region play after that big win yesterday against Dodge. Just popped up on the infield. First baseman Williams calls for it, struggles, and makes a catch as he goes to his knees. Picanto's retired. High, bright sky.
Number nine,
had him fooled a little bit. So Hayden Turner will come to the plate. Turner's walked, been hit by a pitch. He scored one. Runner at second with now two outs. Down low for ball one. Jackets up 4-0 on the Jeff Davis Walk-In Clinic scoreboard. Two in the first, two in the third. Carter Mullis has held the Indians to just one hit. Swing and a miss. One ball, one strike. Neither of these pitchers are going to bust the radar gun with their velocity, but they pitch with a lot of movement. Hit hard but foul, third base. One and two. Need Turner to come through with a two-out hit to get Sayer in from second. The stretch, the 1-2, got him swinging. Back-to-back strikeout, well, not back-to-back, but two strikeouts in the inning for Thomas after the leadoff hit. Jackets leave him stranded at second. We played four. Jackets lead it 4-0. This is the Jeff Davis Hospital Baseball Network.
Cypress Hill Tent Shop, located in Graham, Georgia, offers tinting solutions for every need. Sunroofs, tent matching, removal of old tent, and new installation using state-of-the-art equipment and machines. Cypress Hill Tent Shop uses union tint, guaranteed not to bubble, fade, or discolor over time, and offers both carbon and ceramic tent options. Tint protects the inside of your vehicle and keeps the inside cooler in the summer and warmer in the winter. We also offer pickup and drop-off options for your convenience. Call us today.
Go Jackets!
EP American Footwear in Hazelhurst is proud to be a part of the Hazelhurst Jeff Davis community and are proud sponsors of all Jeff Davis County sports. If you're looking for a great job with a great company, they are hiring for all shifts. You can apply in person Monday through Friday, 8 to 5, at 10 North Hill Street in Hazelhurst. Go Jackets from all the folks at EP American Footwear of Hazelhurst. Go Jackets!
We've got four in the books on the Jeff Davis Walk-In Clinic scoreboard. Four runs, four hits, no errors for the Jackets. No runs, one hit, no errors for the Indians. Derek Queen of Hazelhurst takes us to the top of the fifth. The Mincy, Williams, and Jones. First pitch right at Jackson Sayer on a big candy hop. Throw to first in time. One pitch, one out. He got a nice Sunday hop on a Tuesday afternoon.
Next up, number five, Riley.
I'll bring Riley Williams to the plate, who grounded to second, left-handed batter. Step in. Carter Mullis unofficially at about 67 pitches. Call strike on the outside corner to the lefty. Mullis after struggling to find his control point has another strike, 0-2. In the first inning where he walked two batters, but the pitcher's best friend, the 5-3 double play, got him out of the inning. Checked his swing on a pitch low and away. 1-2. Since then, he's only allowed one base runner. High chop right in front of the plate. Kerlock steps out, takes it, throws to first in time. Two away. Good thing he had a 6'4" first baseman to throw to as he tried to loop that one over the runner who was kind of cutting inside the baseline to try to affect the throw. Carson Jones will be the batter. He struck out his first time. Inside for ball one. Carter's collected four strikeouts. We got two outs here in the fifth. Up and away, 2-0. No Williams Brothers Trucking Company home runs so far. 3-0 the count after cruising along. All of a sudden, Carter falling behind the number eight batter with nobody on and two outs. a 3-0 pitch. Right at the top of the strike zone for a call strike. The 3-1, that missed inside. And that's the third walk issued by Mullis. So runner aboard with two outs for Ashton Pitts, who flied out to left. Left-handed hitting center fielder will step in. Mullis will move to the stretch. Mason at first shading his eyes, trying to hold the runner on. There's a strike on the outside corner. It's a dangerous time to try a pickoff. And there's a little patch of sunshine right in line with first base. Runner with a pretty big lead over there. That one looked better than the first one, but it's said it was outside. A ball and a strike, the count. One on, two outs. Jackets lead at 4-0 on the Jeff Davis Walking Clinic scoreboard in this Region 1 AA matchup. Jackets coming in today, 6-0 in region play. The Indians at just a game back at 5-1, so this is a important game, the first of three against the Indians this week. Missed low and away. Two balls and a strike. So Mullis, who was just cruising along after getting two easy outs this inning, has walked a batter and now fallen behind the number nine hitter. Right back up the middle, but shortstop Saunders is going to field it, step on the bag, and that's going to end the inning. No runs, no hits, no errors, one left. We go to the bottom of the fifth, Jackets up, 4-0. 60-second break. This is the Jeff Davis Hospital Baseball Network.
Your eyes are your window to the world around you, and good vision is important to everyone. At Southern Eye Care, you can count on their expertise in treating all types of vision problems to help you see your best. From glasses to contact lenses, from surgical vision correction to treatment of eye disease and injury, their team is here to help take care of your eyes. Your vision matters at Southern Eye Care in Hazelhurst. Call them for an appointment at 912-375-2516 or visit them online at southerneyecarepc.com.
Experience a better way to bank at Interstate Credit Union in Hazelhurst, where they offer a wide variety of loans. Interstate Credit Union is second to none when it comes to low rates and great customer service, specializing in personal loans, new home and construction loans, and automobile loans, as well as many other types. Their broad services include personal checking, savings, business, in-person, online, and mobile banking, and much, much more. Visit them at 14 Henson Street, or call 912-375-0640, or you can contact them online at interstatecu.org.
Derek Queen of Hazelhurst takes us to the bottom of the fifth. Jackets still up 4-0. Be 3-4-5 in the batting order for the Jackets. Stone, Mullis, and Mason. Stone, Mason, and Mullis.
Leading off for the Jackets, number 7, Duke Stone.
Stone has tripled in two trips. Drove in a run and scored a run. Got the bats up here at the right time. Let's do some damage here in the bottom of the fifth inning. Never comfortable with any lead against this Indian team. Upstairs for ball one. This has been always a traditionally very scrappy team that fights you to the last pitch of the game. It's all the way to the backstop, 2-0 to Stone. See if he just missed a Williams Brothers Trucking Company home run on his first at bat to dead center field. Let's see if he can pull one this time. 3-0 the count. Now, see if Coach Paul Glass standing down at third base. We're going to give Stone a green light, 3-0. nowhere near for ball four. So a four-pitch walk to start the inning. The Jackets designated hitter. I'll bring Alex Mason to the plate. Malachi Smith is going to come on as the pinch runner. Good speed at first now with nobody out.
14, Alex Mason.
Mason has grounded to short and been hit by a pitch. He's scored one and driven in one. So a fast runner at first with nobody out. Coach Glass trying to take advantage of having his four or five hitters up, put some extra speed on the bases to try to push a run across. It's upstairs for ball one. If Alex can shoot a gap, Malachi would have a chance to score all the way from first with his speed. Call strike on the inside corner. Thank our sponsors, Cypress Hill Tent Shop, McCarty Auto Parts, and Three Rivers Meat Company. Runner goes. Grounded to third, but foul. Smith will have to return to first base. One and two the count to Mason, the future Georgia Southern Eagle. Right-handed batter with a bit of a closed stance. Popped it up on the infield. Right by the third base foul line, drifting into foul territory, then falling back into fair territory. Jones makes the catch. That's the second infielder we've seen go to the ground trying to catch a pop-up. One away for Carter Mullis. Mullis flied to right, drove in a run with a fielder's choice. Jackets up 4-0. Run at first, now one out. Runner goes, high pitch. Throw down is not in time. Shortstop couldn't quite handle the throw. It'll give Malachi a stolen base. A ball and no strikes to Carter Mullis. Anybody got any word on the tennis matches going over against Bering County? Give us a shout. Chopper, third base. Third baseman fields. Have to make a long throw across. Gets Mullis by half step. Smith will move to third. I'll bring Trayton Webster, who's 2-for-2 with an RBI. Runner at third, big potential insurance run over there, but there are two outs. Checked his swing on a pitch up around the shoulders. From the stretch, low and in to the lefty, 2-0. Three balls, no strikes. So Webster with a count in his favor with the big run at third with two outs. See if he can come through with a clutch hit. But he's going to draw a four-pitch walk. He's going to put Jackets on the corners with two outs for Jude Worthington. Jude has a sacrifice and a soft liner to short. That's going to get the Dodge County coach out of the dugout. Got Thomas unofficially at 71 pitches. The infield, all the infielders and the catcher gather up on the bump. Our next broadcast will be Thursday instead of Friday. from Dodge County High School. Be a doubleheader with first pitch scheduled in game one at 4 o'clock. Game two will follow about 30 minutes after the completion of game one. So mark your schedules and be sure to be ready to go Thursday. We're going to get an EP American Footwear pitching change before Jude Worthington sets in. Let's take a break. This is the Jeff Davis Hospital Baseball Network.
At Jeff Davis Hospital in Hazelhurst, we are committed to building a healthy community. We use the latest technology, and our knowledgeable team members provide exceptional, state-of-the-art care to our local community and surrounding areas. We provide a respectful understanding of care for our patients and their loved ones. For more information about Jeff Davis Hospital and the services we provide, call 912-375-7781 or visit us online at jeffdavishospital.org.
Dr. Kurt Monsiak and his staff at the Jeff Davis Walk-In Clinic have proudly served this community as the original walk-in clinic for your sick visit needs and as volunteer sports medicine for all our Jeff Davis athletics since 2014. Whether at the clinic, on the sidelines, courtside, matside, or on the diamond, Dr. Kirk is always ready to help. Give him a call at 912-375-4884 or pop in at 22 Cross Street in Hazelhurst behind Jeff Davis Hospital. God bless and go Jackets from the Jeff Davis Walk-In Clinic.
Back here in the EPF American Footwear pitching change, Chris Johnson comes on for the new pitcher for Dodge County. Holden Thomas goes 4 2/3, 4 hits, 4 runs to this point, but the 2 runners on base belong to him. 4 walks, 2 hit batters, and 1 strikeout. Landon Sheffield is the batter. So Jude Worthington will step in. Runner goes to second. The throw down, not in time. Webster steals a base and puts 2 in scoring position. A ball and no strikes, a count to Jude. 2 in scoring position with 2 outs. If Jude can come through with a clutch hit. High fly ball, center field. Center fielder drifts back. He's got room to make the catch. That's going to end the inning. Jackets get a couple of walks, but strand them both. And we've got completed 5. Jeff Davis leads it 4-0. This is the Jeff Davis Hospital Baseball Network.
Need salvage parts for your new or late model car or truck? Then you should call McCarty Auto Parts, where parts arrive daily, Monday through Friday, 8 to 5, at their location at 118 Ottawa Hall Road in Hazelhurst. Check out their inventory online 24/7 at McCartyAuto.com. If they don't have the parts you need, they'll find it. Call McCarty Auto Parts in Hazelhurst for all your salvage part needs. 1-800-329-7258. Go Jackets.
Make the switch to Mitch. Visit Designs and More by Brandy, located inside Mitch's Pharmacy. Brandy offers all occasion flowers, silk, and fresh. Shop Designs and More by Brandy for gift baskets for that special someone, shoes by Corky, and jacket t-shirts for the entire family. Located at 5 East Coffee Street in Hazelhurst, open 9 to 6 Monday through Friday and 9 to 12 on Saturday. Give them a call at 912-699-3784. And follow them on Facebook.
Go Jackets!
The Hazelhurst Dairy Queen rolls us into the top of inning 6. Jackets up 4-0 on the Jeff Davis Walk-In Clinic scoreboard. Going to be the top of the order for the Indians. Moore, Yon, and Landon Fordham. Carter Mullis still on the bump for the Jackets. Will kick and fire. And paint a strike. 1-0. Moore's walked and grounded to second. And he's going to go to second again. Ethan to Alex. A little bit of a low throw, but Mason digs it out. and one away. I'll bring up Kendall Yon. As pitch hitter for Fordham. Check that. Kendall Yon's the second batter. He's sacrificed and grounded to second. Again, to get off track on my scorebook. He's going to hit this one towards short. Eli with a backhanded pickup. Rifles it across the diamond. Alex Mason just had to receive that one chest high. Quickly, two outs here in the fifth.
Next up, number seven, Landon Fordham.
That'll bring Landon Fordham to the plate now, who's walked and has the Indians only hit a one-out double in the fourth. In the top of the sixth, he's going to hit one high and deep to left. See if this one's going to stay in the park. Jude Worthington with an amazing catch. Let's check and see if we can catch that on the Bankhazer assistant replay. Hope he doesn't run out of our picture here. You see Worthington, yeah, he's going to be down in that corner, and that makes an outstanding circus catch. Three up, three down, go the Indians, and what a play by left fielder Jude Worthington over the shoulder, running away from the ball down in the corner. And that ends the inning. 4-0 Jackets as we go to the bottom of the sixth on the Jeff Davis Hospital Baseball Network.
Williams Brothers Trucking is now hiring qualified CDL Class A licensed drivers with at least 2 years over-the-road tractor-trailer experience.
Williams Brothers Trucking has an excellent benefits package. They have quarterly bonuses. They have great insurance.
They offer flexibility as far as your work schedule. You're not really pressured into starting at any certain time throughout the day.
Be home every day with family-owned and operated Williams Brothers Trucking. Apply now online.
Go Jackets!
Dairy Queen of Hazelhurst is proud to sponsor Jeff Davis Athletics. Whether you're celebrating a victory or cheering on your favorite team, DQ Hazelhurst is the ultimate destination for post-game happiness. Fuel your winning spirit with our mouth-watering grill burgers and cool off with our signature soft-serve ice cream. The perfect way to celebrate every triumph on and off the field. Make Dairy Queen Hay.
We move to the bottom of the sixth. Brought to you by the Dairy Queen of Hazelhurst. Jackets going to send 8-9-1 to the plate. Sayer, Saunders, and Picanso.
Leading off with Jackets, number six, Jackson Sayer.
Sheffield will continue to work on the mound for the Indians. Jackets up 4-0 on the Jeff Davis Walk-In Clinic scoreboard. Getting late, and a few more runs wouldn't hurt off the end of the bat foul. Sheffield, the second pitcher sent to the mound by the Indians. Thank our streaming partner, the Beasley Group. Call strike on the inside corner. It's 0-2. You see their logo down in the bottom right-hand corner of your screen. The 0-2 pitch. High pop into right center field. Gavin Fordham, the right fielder, will come over and make the catch for out number one. We'll bring Eli Saunders to the plate.
Up the bat, number 13, Eli Saunders.
Eli has grounded the third and struck out. Kind of in a bit of a slump here as he flinched on that one like it was coming inside, and the breaking ball caught the inside corner for a call strike. Low and outside corner, low, and a strike two. Well, he is. Home plate umpire lows that low and away strike. He's called it a lot today. That one's a little bit too far low and away and skips all the way to the screen. It's 1-2. Jackets got two in the first. Stone a RBI triple. Alex Mason drove in Stone with a infield ground out. The 1-2 pitch. inside, 2-2. Jackets got two more in the second. As Canso led off with a walk, Mason was later hit by a pitch. Carter Mullis pushed one across with a fielder's choice, swing and a miss. And Saunders is down on strike. And then Trayton Webster, a two-out hit to drive in the fourth run of the game. First strikeout. For Sheffield, Picanso steps in and takes ball one. Ethan has flied to left, walked and scored, and popped to first. Call strike. Generous call at the top of the strike zone. Gosh, Ethan isn't that tall. Upstairs. Might have been a strike on Stone or Mason, but not sure that was in the letter highs on this Ethan, who's has to swing and miss a shoulder high pitch there for strike two. 2-2, two outs, and the base is empty. Low and away. Count full now, 3-2, with nobody on, two outs. Sheffield on in release of Thomas. We're in the bottom of inning six. Jackets clinging to a 4-0 lead on the Jeff Davis Walk-In Clinic scoreboard. The payoff pitch had hit him. Tried to come inside, but got a little too far in. So Ethan will trot to first. Hayden Turner's been hit by a pitch and scored. Walked and struck out. That big gap in right center still sitting there. Missed inside for ball one. Center fielder Pitts has shaded every right-handed batter about 5 or 6 steps towards left. And he's going to go that way in the gap in right center field. Right fielder, those going to get over and cut it off. Will hold everybody to one base, or two-out hit by Turner keeps the inning going. First and second with two outs. Hit number 5 for the Jackets. That bring Duke Stone to the plate. Stone is tripled. Fly to right and walked. See if the future Mississippi State Bulldog can do some damage here. He's going to take a strike at the upper limits of the strike zone. Right-handed batter waggles the bat. That one's over his head. 1-1, the count. A bit of a crouch. The waggle bat almost touching his back of his shoulder. Almost hit him. All right, about the shoulder. 2-1, the count. So two ducks on the pond here with two outs. Well, insurance wouldn't hurt. Swing and a miss at a fastball low and away. It's 2-2, and Duke's going to take a step out and adjust the batting gloves. All right, climbs back in the box. Runners lead from first and second. The stretch and the 2-2. Hit on the ground, third. Third baseman's going to scoop it up, step on the bag, and that will end the inning. Jackets leave two on one hit and a hit batter. We've got 6 in the books. Go to the top of the 7th. Got to hold them, Jackets. Jeff Davis leads it 4-0. This is the Jeff Davis Hospital Baseball Network.
Dairy Queen of Hazelhurst is proud to sponsor Jeff Davis Athletics. Whether you're celebrating a victory or cheering on your favorite team, DQ Hazelhurst is the ultimate destination for post-game happiness. Fuel your winning spirit with our mouth-watering grill burgers and cool off with our signature soft-serve ice cream. The perfect way to celebrate every triumph on and off the field. Make Dairy Queen Hazelhurst your post-game tradition, because in Hazelhurst, we know how to score big on flavor and fun.
Go Jackets!
At Altamaha Hall Bank and Trust, we strive to help you live your best life. That means offering loans for nearly any dream or goal. With competitive rates, local process.
Dairy Queen of Hazelhurst takes us to the top of the seventh inning. Jackets up 4-0, so we got to hold them right here. Carter Mullis will step to the mound. He's got him unofficially about 83 pitches. Andrew White was warming up earlier down in the Jacket bullpen. Call strike. 0-1. So after a kind of a rough first inning with Carter walked two, able to induce a double play to get out of the inning, he's settled down and strike two. Only given up a one-out double in the fourth. 0-2 the count to Holden Thomas. Has a little soft liner that's going to drop into right center field. Webster over quickly. A leadoff hit by Thomas. Just their second hit of the game. Gives the Indians some life here in the seventh. Gavin Fordham's 0 for 2 with a strikeout. They might be getting a the courtesy runner for the designated hitter. So Johnson at first with one out. Fordham hits it hard but fouled down the third base line. He was about 2 feet away from extra bases. Thanks Cypress Hill Tent Shop, McCarty Auto Parts, and Three Rivers Meat Company for sponsoring Yellow Jacket Baseball. Be sure to stay tuned after the game, the Southern Eye Care postgame show, where we'll have player interviews and also have a chat with head coach Paul Glass. Jackets trying to go 7-0 in the region. Good stop by Kerlock as that pitch was low and away. And he slid out on his knees and kept it out in front of him to keep the runner at first base. One ball and one strike. Thank everyone that's tuned in on our Beasley Group live stream today on YouTube. That one missed wide. It's 2-1. Gavin Fordham steps back in the right-handed batter's box. Mullis from the stretch. It's wide. 3-1. And you can just sense Coach Paul Glass sitting on the edge of his stool down there in the Jacket dugout. Carter, once again, struggling to find the strike zone. And there's a walk that puts two on with nobody out. And that's what we talk about, these Dodge County Indians. They never quit. And that does get Coach Paul Glass out of the dugout. Carter Mullis, we got him right around 91 pitches unofficially. And we are going to get a EP American footwear pitching change. So Coach Glass takes the ball from Mullis. He'll move over to play first. Mason will slip across to play third. And Jackson Sayer will move in from third to pitch. Let's take a break. This is the Jeff Davis Hospital Baseball Network.
The Bank of Hazelhurst is Jeff Davis County's only locally owned and operated bank. serving their friends and family since 1906. They offer a wide array of services, including personal, commercial, and electronic banking services, along with mortgage and ag lending. For more information on the services they offer, call them at 912-375-4228. Download their banking app or contact them online at bankofhazelhurst.com. The Bank of Hazelhurst. When others have their branches, they have their roots.
Since their founding in 1968, the Beasley Group has become a vertically integrated leader in the forest products industry, and this growth has made them the largest hardwood sawmill in the United States and North America's foremost producer of crane mats and timbers for the energy transmission, utility, and construction industries. The Beasley Group is proud to be members of the Hazelhurst and Jeff Davis County community. They are also proud supporters of all Jeff Davis High School sports. Go Jackets!
EP American Footwear, Jackson Sayer takes the mound. Carter Mullis goes six innings plus two batters here in the seventh. Two hits, no runs to this point, but the two runners do belong to him. Three walks, four strikeouts. Sayer from the stretch. 65 miles an hour for a called strike at the top of the strike zone. Mincy's 0 for 2 with a strikeout. Runners first and second, nobody out. Top of the seventh, Jackets up by four, but Dodge threatening. High chop. Mason's going to step on third for one. Fire across. Mullis pulls it up, but they say the runner beat the throw. Five unassisted at Thirst. Coach Paul Glass is going to come out of the dugout to. Looked like he got him at first by a half step. Carter made a big scoop. Let's see, do we have that on the Bank of Hazelhurst instant replay? And the umpires are going to speak it over. You see Mason, they had the throw to first. Oh, man. I believe he did get him by a half step. Of course, the base umpire was over between second and third. And they again say he is safe on the fielder's choice. So one away, got the cut down the lead runner. Alex was about, had to take about two steps to get to the bag for the force. We're going to get another pinch runner. Going to check in the game. That's so Pruitt in as the runner at first. First and second, one away. And that'll bring Riley Williams to the plate. He's 0 for 2. Left-handed batter, Sayer. From the stretch, as a one-hopper, two-hopper, three-hopper to short. They get one, throw to first, not in time. They get the force at second. Hit too slowly to turn the double play. So another fielder's choice. Runners first and third. Now two outs. And the last chance for the Indians is going to be Carson Jones, who's walked and struck out. Runners on the corners with two outs. Jackets up 4-0 on the Jeff Davis Walking Clinic scoreboard. Trying to go 7-0 in Region 1 AA play. From the stretch. Runner goes. Throw goes down. They got the runner hung up now. Runner at third. They're going to get him at second. The run scores. And that's going to be your ball game. So run does cross the plate to score before the game ends, but Riley Williams is caught stealing, and that's going to be your ball game. So Dodge does score a run on one hit, no errors, and one left. So our final score is 4-1. Jeff Davis with the win. Let's take a two-minute timeout. Stay tuned for the Southern Eye Care postgame show.
Since their founding in 1968, the Beasley Group has become a vertically integrated leader in the forest products industry, and this growth has made them the largest hardwood sawmill in the United States and North America's foremost producer of crane mats and timbers for the energy transmission, utility, and construction industries. The Beasley Group is proud to be members of the Hazelhurst and Jeff Davis County community. They are also proud supporters of all Jeff Davis High School sports. Go Jackets from the Beasley Group.
CNH Creative Flooring can make your floors beautiful. They are this area's foremost experts when it comes to concrete grinding, polishing, crack repair, and epoxy coatings. They offer hundreds of color epoxy flake systems to choose from, custom metallics, neat coats, inlaid emblems, and much more. Whether it's your home, garage, man cave, pool deck, sidewalks, porches, or carport, let us help you make it gorgeous, safe, colorful, and skid resistant. Call Daryl Hutto at 912-381-9037 or Cody Carter at 912-592-5493 or message them on Facebook.
Cypress Hill Tent Shop, located in Graham, Georgia, offers tenting solutions for every need. Sunroofs, tent matching, removal of old tent, and new installation using state-of-the-art equipment and machines. Cypress Hill Tent Shop uses union tent, guaranteed not to bubble, fade, or discolor over time, and offers both carbon and ceramic tent options. Tent protects the inside of your vehicle and keeps the inside cooler in the summer and warmer in the winter. We also offer pickup and drop-off options for your convenience. Call us today.
Go Jackets!
EP American Footwear in Hazelhurst is proud to be a part of the Hazelhurst Jeff Davis community and are proud sponsors of all Jeff Davis County sports. If you're looking for a great job with a great company, they are hiring for all shifts. You can apply in person Monday through Friday, 8 to 5 at 10 North Hill Street in Hazelhurst. Go Jackets from all the folks at EP American Footwear of Hazelhurst. Go Jackets! NICARE post-game show. Jackets a winner here. Four runs, five hits, no errors for the Jackets. One run, two hits, no errors for the Indians. Carter Mullis picks up the win, his second of the season. Jackson Sayer gets the save. And first up here is tonight's winning pitcher, Carter Mullis. Carter, congratulations on the win tonight.
Thank you.
That's always a tough team, Dodge. It's a big region win. We're now 7-0 in the region. And they were just a game behind us, so that gives us a little breathing room right there.
Yes, sir. They were a real scrappy team, real young team. They were real scrappy. They stayed in it the whole game. It felt a whole lot. They made it feel like it was a whole lot closer than what it was.
And that's the thing with Dodge County over the years. You never feel comfortable. You could have a 7 or 8 run lead and still not feel comfortable with those guys because traditionally they're scrappy and they claw and, like they say, they hit the last inning and they finally get on the board. But that's you got to fight them to the last out.
Yes, sir. They're one of them teams that they're just so stubborn they never know when to go away.
All right. Congratulations on the win tonight.
Thanks.
Carter Mullis joining us here on the Southern Eye Care postgame show. Hayden Turner comes in. Hayden, congratulations on getting a big region win tonight. Had a hit and a walk and a hit batter, so you had a kind of rough night at the plate there.
Yes, sir, I did. I just had to find me a break right there at the end, and y'all was throwing a little bit harder, and I stayed on it, so.
Well, it's you got to find ways to win that walk that the hit by pitch you got in that first inning turned into a run. So, you get on base and try to help the guys behind you push you around.
Yeah, I mean that ball's coming at you. You just got to stay in there, man.
Well, it wasn't thrown very hard, was it?
No, sir.
It looked like it was the one that was a softer pitch. So, yeah. those are not too bad to take on the on the bat. Big region win 7-0 in the region. And now we have to head over there on Thursday for a doubleheader. You guys seem to be kind of finding your groove here.
Yes, sir. We just got to keep it going. Have a good day at practice tomorrow and get ready for Thursday. So,
congratulations on the win.
Yes, appreciate it.
Hayden Turner joined us here. Duke Stone comes in. Duke got us going with a big triple in the first inning and came in to score, get us up 2-0. Tell us a little bit about what's going on out there. It looked like we were having trouble trying to get timing on the first guy.
Yes, sir. We were just kind of sitting out front, and he couldn't really – he's kind of mixing us up. He mixed in a changeup every now and then that kind of got us guessing a little bit. But Carter pitched it really good.
He sure did.
Kind of keep us in the game right there, not really have to rely on hitting as much as we should have. But
well, he kind of struggled that first in, but the defense bails him out with a 5-3 double play. And you always like to get those twin killings out there.
Oh, yes, sir. great play by Eli there. Mm-hmm. Surely all around great defense and pitching that really carries.
That's the other thing. Besides getting good pitching, our defense has been real solid.
Yes, sir. We practice it hard. So.
All right. Congratulations on the win.
Thank you.
Duke Stone. Trayton Webster comes in. Trayton, a couple of hits today. You swinging the bat well. Got to pick up two hits and an RBI in three trips. Actually, you got a walk, too. You're on base all three times.
Yes, sir.
All right. Tell us a little bit about what you saw at the plate today and you know, being able to get a pick up a big RBI there with a two-out hit.
My first at-bat wasn't very good, but mm-hmm. I was way out in front on it. It's out, so I pitched. I tried to pull it. And next at-bat, stayed through it.
I think that was one that went right back up the middle, wasn't it?
Yes, sir. I knew I had to score somebody.
Right. And you got runners on the base. Those two-out hits, I've heard Coach Glass talk about them for years now. Not just the two-out hits, but the two-out RBI hits. What that can do to break the morale of the other team.
Yes, sir. Push them down a little bit.
All right. Defense playing, again, lights out. You guys, I know, are working hard every day on defense.
Yes, sir.
All right. Congratulations on the win today. Trayton Webster, center fielder. Jude Worthington comes in. Jude, we tried to get you on our Bank of Hazelhurst Instant Replay for that catch out in left field, but you ran out of our camera range.
Yes, sir.
Tell us a little bit about the catch, man.
It hit off the bat.
Yeah.
And, they say I'm real heavy-footed. It was bouncing on me. I could tell it was running away.
Mm-hmm.
And I just dove at it and hoped, put a glove on it and caught it.
You did. And you had to kind of dive and then roll to avoid it running into the wall down there in the corner, didn't
you? Yes, sir. Caught a piece of that warning track.
Right. Well, I tell you what, now that turned into a big play because that got us out of an inning. And I tell you what, these guys, Dodge County, they didn't quit. They kept coming at us.
Yes, sir. And I knew they was getting close, and Carter was throwing a good game. Mm-hmm. I knew I had to make that play behind Carter.
All right. Go over their place on Thursday for a doubleheader. I tell you what, that's going to be a tall task.
Yes, sir, it is. Hope we come out swinging and as intense as we were this game.
All right. Congratulations on the catch and the big win today. Jude Worthington, left fielder for the Yellow Jackets, who made us a highlight reel-looking catch there. Wish we could have kept that in our camera range. He kind of ran out into the left field corner on that catch there, Coach. So
yeah.
We missed getting him on our Bank Hazelhurst Instant Replay. But great win today, 4-1 over a region foe. So that keeps us undefeated in the region.
Yeah.
Carter pitched a great game, and we did just enough at the plate to get the win.
Yeah, I mean, we told the guys that mm-hmm. none of them have played the Long County teams that we've played in the past and the Brantley County teams. And Dodge County, for some reason, they remind me so much of those guys that no matter what the circumstances are, whether it be what they played a game yesterday or mm-hmm. They took a bad round of pregame or they go whatever the circumstances are,
mm-hmm.
Dodge is one of those teams that will absolutely just keep coming after you, And when we kept squandering opportunities right there, in my mind I'm thinking, man, this is playing right into their hands right here.
We left nine on base, so there you got to.
Yeah, and we did a very bad job, I thought, tonight mm-hmm. as a group of adjusting to the slower off-speed guy at the beginning. We had a few better at-bats, and then all mm-hmm. of a sudden – it's almost like we were running at the ball, and we're running at the fastball.
Mm-hmm.
And we showed a little bit of we were undisciplined at the plate. And weak pop-ups, rollovers, swinging through pitches. And, I mean, we get a runner at second, no outs, and we go strikeout, pop-up, strikeout, something like that.
Yeah.
I mean, that can't happen. I mean, and you get in a region game like this in a tight game, you got a one run is huge right there.
Right.
And luckily, we played really mm-hmm. good defense. I mean, the play that Jude made out there, I mean, that's a tough play going towards the wall.
Right.
You know, you kind of, in your mind, as you're going back, you know that wall is back there somewhere.
Mm-hmm.
You kind of wonder. But he did a good job of just keep going after it. And, mm-hmm. you know, we tell these guys, especially here, as long as you feel grass under your feet, you're not close to anything that's going to bite you.
Right.
So just let it rip. And as long as you feel grass, you're in good shape. So
mm-hmm.
he laid out and made a great play. I thought our infielders played really good today.
Big double play by Jackson at third.
Yeah, I mean, in the first inning.
Yeah.
I mean, golly, that was a big play.
Carter kind of struggled in the first, and he got bailed out with a double play.
Oh, yeah. And, this is one of those games, and if you pitch long enough, mm-hmm. you're going to have a game like this where you don't got your great stuff, you don't got command,
mm-hmm.
you can't really get – he didn't get a really good feel of his changeup. So you have to find a way. You have to gut it out. And you just got to battle. And I mean, that sounds
that's what he did.
Like coach speak. But, I mean, you got to have a guy on the mound who is just stubborn and in a good way.
That's
I don't mean
that's
that in
that
a bad
senior
way.
Mentality
yeah.
there.
And Carter, and there's a reason why we're starting him game one in these region series right now is because he does have that mentality. I mean, you ask those – anybody that's watched him play football, he's not going to be passive and he's not going to be, you know, kind of wait and see. He's going to come after you. And if he makes a mistake, he's just going to keep coming after you. And that's what you got to do.
Yeah, four-year start at linebacker. Yeah. You know you got some grit in there.
Yeah, and he's that's why we want that kind of mentality and we want that mentality to rub off on everybody too. Right. And, you know, a lot of times your defense will take the mentality of your pitcher. And Carter, they said he was struggling and, you know, he just couldn't really find it, and you know, he got a little bit of contact and made a few plays behind him. So, it's like Coach Weems said before I came up. He said, "An ugly win is better than a pretty loss."
Hey, you know, every day.
Yeah, man, we don't apologize for winning.
That's
it's gonna be tough going up there to their place and winning two games at their.
Got to go play two on Thursday instead of Friday. Right. We move it up, try to get ahead of the weather.
Right.
And again, always. You know, we've been there. We haven't been there very much. We had them in our region early on when I started doing this, and then a big gap there. But I remember going over there when they had those loaded teams with kids going to Ole Miss and Auburn, and then you get that sun delay about the middle of the game.
Yeah,
we had to wait for a while to get the sun out of the batter's eyes. So
this field will have good memories for Coach Brown. I think he hit a home run up there.
I think
there.
So,
I think he hit two home runs,
I think he may have.
Hit one on top of that house over there, but I don't even know if that – it's been so long since we've been there. Last year we were there, but it before that, like you said, it was a big gap, and they just they've had some guys that could just mash and play. And that last kid that pitched right there, he's going to be a good one for them. He's just a little sophomore, but he don't look like one. He don't play like one.
No, he don't.
He's good. I mean, I've seen these guys play, and they know how to win. They know how to play, and they play hard and they fight. And when you know, just right there in the last, right there, they just keep swinging. They keep coming at you.
Right.
You know that's really what you want your teams to do. You know, and that's something that no matter what your talent level is, that's something that everybody can do.
That's
you just got to be willing to do it. And you know, Coach Herring does a good job of getting those guys just to keep coming after you. And look, if you ain't gonna come after your opponent, you're gonna really lower your chances of being successful.
That's right.
So, I mean, he does a good job of getting that instilled in them. And to go up there and to win one game is gonna be tough. To try to win two is gonna be really tough. So you know, right now it's just a one game. We just got to go win one game, and then whatever happens in that game, we try to win another game if we play another game. So, you know, that you got to be – I know this sounds like coach speak again, but you got to go one game at a time.
One at a time.
You go up there and you say, well, we got to win two. No, you got to win one.
You can't win the second one until you win the first one.
You can't turn a double play unless you get the first out.
That's
so we need to go up there and win one game, and then what happens after that happens after that.
Well, Coach, congratulations on the win today.
Thank
and let's get a good day of practice and go get them on Thursday.
Right.
Coach Paul Glass here on the Southern Eye Care postgame show. Once again, our final score, Jeff Davis, a winner here, 4-1 over Dodge County to go to 7-0 in region play and even up our overall record now at 7-7. So for my sidekick here, Ethan Dixon, this is Jim Sewell bidding everyone